We have a lot of sell signals today. And remember, kids, the stock market or stonks typically take the steps to my left or my right up, but end up taking the elevator on the way down. And everyone is selling AMC. Weren't you just buying it yesterday? And honest to Buddha, or honest to Jim Cramer, little buddy. My phone was blowing up. My friends were like, should we buy AMC? And I'm like, no. They're like, why not? I'm like, watch my video, which was yesterday. So I'm like, I've shot a video just for you. And gold took a beating today. And rarely will you hear me say, buy the dip, but it's gold. And buy the dip. So I changed my background. Now that's probably a little bit more apropos. Maybe I should sell a hoodie that says buy the dip, or a hoodie that says HODL, right? Something. But we are actually talking about all of those. We're talking about AMC today. What is going on? We're talking about gold. So I'm squeezing in silver for you. You guys need to see these charts. You're just going to go, wow. I mean, unless you don't care about securing wealth or building wealth, then I guess you could just turn on the TV and listen to these guys, right? That would be probably even more beneficial. Because I guess at the end of the day, if you're not doing anything, it really doesn't matter. Just flip on the news. What do we got here? AMC files to sell 11 million shares, hitting stock temporarily. I don't think that's temporarily. I think they know when a good time to come in is. You gotta know when to hold them, when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, know when to run. And I'm so glad that we have experts. Experts explain why AMC stock tanked on news. It planned to sell 11 million shares. This is not the line you want to hold. When you see a hockey stick formation, that's usually a good signal of like, it's gonna come down. It almost looks like it just blends in with the line. Like, it's like, wait, where is it? Hold on. Let me move it for you so you can see that. I do not think it is a good idea. That's just me. You know, call me terrible financial advice. You know, what do I know? But when you have something launch like this, this is a one-day candle of over 100%. What are the, and this is when I got the texts and the phone calls, and they're like, should I get in? And I'm like, no. In my opinion, you had two spots. When that buy indicator popped up right above that 9-day moving average, there was one entry, and there with it, clearly there was your second. And if you're new to the stock market, I will turn on my Heikinashis for you so you can kind of see a momentum. You see? There's a momentum. Also, you're above the 50 and the 200, and you're looking hot. Smoking hot on that MACD. And also in regards to the MACD, McDonald's, I'm not going to pull it up, but you have a negative divergence on that. So for some reason, you're holding McDonald's, look out below. Also, if you would like to control your wealth rather than allow other people to control it, where it actually looks like you have some brain cells, I currently have two. They're both on overdrive 24/7. I will leave a link in the description for you for like 70-ish% off of my course on how I do this. You come over onto your computer, you click trade, and you buy. Just like that. Oh, wait. We only do paper trading on this channel. Also, link in the description. If you guys want, this is free. Trade. This is what I use. Trading View. I actually use this as examples in the classroom. Down here, trades I would never make. my students are like, what about ARK? I'm like, watch. Right-click buy. What about Coinbase? Right-click buy. What about Jeff? It looks to me like those were some really bad trades that should have been exited out of a long time ago. So let me just close out showing you how you enter and exit trades, right? You're like, no, Bravo, hold, buy and hold. Also, I would never, I saw that market. I never do market buy, never do market sell. Now on to bigger and better things like gold retreats after Fed stimulus comments, dollar gains. Look at that, like right on cue. And I don't know if they make some phone calls or like, we got a golden cross approaching on gold. We have a golden cross on, so you guys need to look at this chart. This is crazy. So then they bring out one of the Fed presidents. Let's do Philly. All right. You guys know Patrick? All right. Patrick, this is what you're going to say. Got to kind of code the words as if we're going to stop buying bonds, which there is no way in Hades that the Fed is going to stop buying bonds. That's like saying my wife is going to stop buying. Like, it's not possible. No, I know she may say, no, you know what? I looked at the credit card bill and I should probably slow down a little bit. And that's what they said. To slowly, carefully move back. I mean, even like you try to use that as a soundbite, you can't. How do you even, you know, to slowly, carefully move back on bond purchases at a suitable time? But I have some good news and bad news. It is a 100% Fed bond buying driven economy. We don't have an economy. They just keep swapping it with the banks until this thing finally ends. And when it does, oh boy, it will be like 4th of July in your bedroom. And you will be seeing more and more stories that look like this from CNBC Pro. Wall Street analyst foresee a 40% drop in the average meme stock led by an AMC wipeout. Well, he did pretty good. 40%? Yeah, I mean, come on. To the means, he can't go up 50-100%. You're going to come back down. And as the article points out, speculative trading from retail investors active on Reddit's Wall Street Bets forum are taking these meme stock to new heights. The stock includes AMC, GameStop, BlackBerry, BB&B. It's that Beyond part. I want to know where that's at. I know we're a bed and bath, but the Beyond gets a little nervous. But I would never, GameStop wouldn't mess with that one. Three things that I know never to mess with in life. One of them is you GameStoppers, all love. You Dogecoiners, nothing but love. Then number three is the Google algorithms. Woo, gotta keep the channel going. And actually, Carlson did a scathing piece on Fox about what we have experienced in the last year, and there's certain words that I cannot say. Otherwise, this video will get shelved to eternity, but That was some crazy, 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 crazy. But I wanted to show you AMC, and some good news is something that you can't see, but I'll tell you. These are the next Reddit stocks to watch according to Bank of America. You want to know? I'll tell you. We'll just sneak on down there. We'll go over AMC, GameStop, Virgin, and Beyond Meat. Look at that short interest percentage of float for Beyond Meat, but I do not want to trade Beyond Meat right now. I just wanted to point that in your direction, and also point another thing in your direction where I'm just like, what the frack? Did you guys happen to see this? We had this perfect golden cross on silver. Everyone's like, yeah, we're gonna have a no. It just got just beat down. There is now no golden cross on silver. I wonder if there could be manipulation that triggers algorithms. You think? Maybe not. Maybe. What do I know? But look at this. You had that huge buy right here. My buy signal, one candle close above that. It's all in the course. You got this. I'm sorry, at 12%, you got to exit your trade. But the good news is we're above the 200, above the 50. So there will be more. Actually, as a chicken, I have chicken hands. My entry was there. My exit was definitely there, unless I missed something. Which, by looking at it, I did. I missed that one. I would have exited there, re-entered there. That's the thing about swing trading. It's like, ooh, enter, exit, enter, exit. And then people come onto this channel. They're like, you said gold was going to go down. I'm like, it did. And then I'm like, gold's going to go up. Did you miss that video? Looking at gold. Oh, I got to move over. Wait, maybe I'll move my chart. Hold on 1 second. There we go. All right, we are back and we have action. All right, so we came above, right? That 50. Oh, that was a good buy. Good. Well, we're underneath the 200. This was, if you swing trade underneath the 200, which I typically do not, we are above the 200, and we are closing our position now. But look at that. Look what is forming right where I put the arrow, right about there, unless they screw it all up for us kids with their manipulation. You have a golden cross on gold. You're above the 50. You're above the 200. The Heikinashis are looking pretty. Is that even Heikinashi? But your MACD, sorry, kids, got to exit. But it's okay. It's just paper. This right there. This is just a paper. It's not even real gold. And I actually had George Gammon on the channel. Video, I don't know when it's going to come out because his video was buffering like this. So I don't know if I just need to release it or add, like, you know, those cute video frames behind it and with the wording, because I respect your time and I want to make sure it's good. This was my death cross right there. Get out. Everyone get out. And then whoop, it died. But now we got a golden cross approaching. We have had a crazy stock market today. Dow erases almost 300-point loss, turns positive, led by economic comeback plays. Because our economy is so darn good, right, kids? Doesn't get any better than our economy. We produce so many goods and services. It's so nice. I mean, we have no unemployment. Our no inflation, everything is good. Coming up here, looking at the S&P 500, pretty mixed bag of nuts up there. You got the NASDAQ, got a little spanking today down. We got about half an hour left, down 1%. S&P down slightly, Russell 2000 down, and then good old Bitcoin posts a 2.5% gain, which 2.5 in normal markets, it'd be like, what is going on? And also for you Bitcoiners, I know you got, you know, you're like, ooh, this could be a short trade right there. You have so many things against you besides it's Bitcoin. I know. You do have a death cross. Let me close that forming. You're under the 50. You're under the 200. And I got one more for you. I was actually looking at this guy's analysis on Bitcoin. I'm like, oh, I have never seen this before. Thank you, my guy. Looking at this, let me grab my little pointer for you so I can show you. These patterns, you had a top one, clearly. Top two, clearly. And top three. So maybe I will go into more detail on this. Looks like he uses the Ichimoku cloud. I can never pronounce that right. Ichimoku cloud. Never trade in the cloud. Never trade below the cloud. Only trade on top of the cloud. And looking at this, it's going to bash its head. Bitcoin's going to bash its head right around 52,000. And then there it goes. Or based on that trend line, maybe about 58,000, 60,000, but no more than that. And how about this? Why don't I just not be lazy and I show you? This is the top of the wick there. You cannot see a wick. That's also the top of the wick there. So probably if I had to guess, you know, what, 50, 51, 50, 52? Yeah, we may bounce off of that, strike it, come down. But if you are a swing trader on the corn, yeah, you had a swing up right there. And then let me change the candles so you guys can see just regular candles to kind of see what that pattern might look like. And I just think a lot of people, oh, they are all going to get sucked in to this trade when it gets right. You're like, oh my gosh, we're above it. We're above the 200. And then people pile in. Just watch that trend line. That is why I show you how to swing, right? No, diamond hands. I don't know. Cotton candy? Or if I had finger-licking chicken on my finger, I'm like, this chicken, it's delicious. You betcha I'm going to lick my fingers. But if crypto makes no sense to you at all, we ditch the annual fee. Check out the new credit card perks. No, don't do that. BlockFi gives you almost 9%. You just park it. You don't have to work. If you're a dip buyer, right? If you're just buy the dips, seems like a good idea to me. Because if it goes down, you can go, well, at least I'm still getting 9% and I can wait for the next bull run. And then continue to accumulate during the bear markets. That's where people really make their money, is in the bear markets. Also, I think BlockFi, I don't know if they still are, link in the description. I think they give you $250 to open up an account just to go, huh, this works. And also at the end of the day, you got to think, you know, do you want to hold dollars? Or do you want to hold something else? Love gold, right? Could there be alternatives? Yes, stonks. Bravo, stonks. Well, that you'd swing trade. So you can hodl Bitcoin because it's really tough to trade. Just know on these, you know, 50% moves, yeah, you have your diapers. Trading crypto is not for the faint of heart. I always get like notifications on my phone. It's like up, DOT is up 20%, down 50%, back up 90%. Not the easiest thing to swing trade, unless maybe it's on the second or minute or daily. But you probably wouldn't have understood anything of what I just said unless you've gone through the course. And look at all the good news that is happening in the United States of America. U.S. jobless claims dip below 500,000. These are new job, 400,000. That's a lot of new jobless claims. I'm like, where have you been in the last year? Now you're like, I just gave up. I can't do it. But the biggest drop in claims, where's it from? Texas. We got some jobs out here. Come on out. Florida with the biggest drop in claims. I'd say that looks really bad, but not so bad, right? But remember back up in here, everyone's like, no, it's fine. Everything's fine. The narrative's always like, it's fine. This is fine. You're okay. I know it's just a little fire, but you'll be okay. And thank you guys for making it to the very end. And I will see you tomorrow.